Cause girls is players too. My heart still feels bad. We just get money all around the world. Living on the top, penthouse suites, looking down on the ops. Took her for a test drive, left them on the lot. Time is money, so I spend it on a watch. Hold on, little titties showing through the white teeth. You can see the thong busting on my tight jeans. Okay, rocks on my fingers like a nigga wife me. Got another shorty, she ain't nothing like me. Yeah, about to catch another fight. Yeah. The apple bottom make him wanna bite. Yeah. I just wanna have a good night. I just wanna have a good night. Hold up, don't know that no. If you broke, then you gotta let him go. You can have anybody, any money, bro. Cause when you're a boss, you could do what you want. Yeah, cause girls is players too. Cause girls is players too. Cause girls is players too. Bitches getting money all around the world. Bitches getting money all around the world.
Everybody is doing like Sunday resets, but I'm doing a Monday reset, and we just gonna make it a whole vlog, spend a day with me, right? Monday reset. And I'm doing Monday because I worked all weekend, and yeah, I wasn't home on Sunday all day to do a Sunday reset, so we doing it on Monday. Okay. We doing it on Monday. But anyway, so I just had to straighten up my kitchen because my husband act like he don't know how to clean up. It's not that hard. Like, he clean, he do his version of cleaning. It ain't my version of cleaning, it's his version of cleaning. So I just be feeling like I don't understand. Like, I just don't get it. It's like, I know I'm a little bit OCD when it comes to cleaning, y'all, but it's like it's just so simple. And it's like, why can't you clean? I think he just really try to, like, I'm not gonna really clean type, like, I don't know. Anyway, he don't be cleaning up right. So I always am the one that cleans my house the way I want to clean it, because don't nobody know how to clean it like I know how to clean it. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, so I had to come down here and finish cleaning up my kitchen. I'm not done. I'm not gonna mop my floor until tonight, because if I mop my floor right now, it ain't gonna do nothing but be a hot ass mess, okay? And I'm gonna have to mop it again, so I'm just gonna go ahead and not mop it until tonight. But yeah, so I'm cleaning up my whole downstairs because it is a hot mess to me. I'm about to start on my dinner. I'm gonna make some fried chicken wings in the air fryer and some corn on the cob with some macaroni and cheese. And it's not like a homemade macaroni and cheese, it's literally the macaroni and cheese that I get from Trader Joe's. If y'all know, y'all know that macaroni and cheese I get from Trader Joe's, I absolutely love it. And I need to put some vinegar in that water, y'all. Hold on. Yeah, I love it, and yeah, it goes good with everything. So let me show y'all. Hold on. So we're gonna do some chicken. Y'all see the chicken. I am trying to clean it. Let me put some vinegar in that water. I always let my chicken soak in vinegar and water. And then, so we let the chicken soak in vinegar, clean it with lemon. I am going to be making the fried chicken. This is the macaroni and cheese, y'all. I love this from Trader Joe's. This is my favorite from Trader Joe's. We're gonna make some broccoli that I'm gonna mix in with the macaroni and cheese and some corn on the cob. But I think I got some open broccoli, so I'm gonna see, because I always got broccoli on deck. So I'm gonna see what bags of broccoli I got open. So I ain't gotta open a new one, because I do see a half bag right there. So that's what we're gonna do. So while my chicken is soaking, yeah, I'm gonna finish straightening up the rest of my house. Like, I need to wipe off my table. And let me do that. Yeah, I feel like I really haven't been home all weekend. Like, I literally just been working, doing deliveries. And I don't know, my house just ain't been like I want it to be. Him and Kariah. Kariah got socks in my chair. Socks. Her socks. Between her socks and his shirts. Like, literally. I'm not even playing. Her socks and his shirts. I'm going to tell him, take your stuff upstairs. And her stuff, her school stuff. She always leaving papers everywhere. I don't know. But yeah, I hate when I be gone all weekend, like working, not really, you know, just coming home, going in my room, going to bed, and not really paying attention to my house. It just seems like it gets out of hand. But yeah, so that is what I am doing, you guys. Like I said, it's Monday, and I need to just get my life together. Let me put this right here. Every time I put this right here, it's too high. It's too high every time. But we're going to work with it for right now. Oh, I left my phone. I left my phone over there. But yeah, I need to vacuum the floor, fix my couches. And that's what I'm about to do. And then get this chicken seasoned up. So I'll be back with y'all once I get the chicken seasoned. I'll be back. Okay, y'all. So I done cleaned my chicken. I was gonna like cut off, you know, this part of the chicken right here, this part, but I don't feel like it. Like, I honestly don't. So what I'm doing is, I just wanted to rinse it off one more time. But I'm done cleaning it. What I'm about to do is season it up, and then I'm going to, hold on. I hate when that drains. Well, come on. Okay, so I'm seasoning the chicken, and I'm using the chicken liquor. Bam, bam. My girl, Erica, put me on to this. And my husband actually loves it. He loves the chicken liquor bam bam. So I use it every time now on the chicken, fried chicken. And I'm also going to add some of this no salt Tony's Creole seasoning. I don't know what kind of seasoning it is, but I always add that. And we are literally about to be out too. So yeah, I'm about to add that. Get all of this water out of here. Okay, now take this off. Oh, I hate touching raw meat. I do not like touching meat, period. So I'm gonna wear gloves every time. So just dump a whole bunch of seasoning on that. This is another basic ass dinner, y'all. My basic ass dinners. Let me know if y'all like my basic dinners. Yeah, we're about to just throw a whole bunch of that on that. I'm probably gonna use all the rest of this. like a clump in here. Well, yep, that's it. That's it for that. And what I normally do is I just mix it up. I'm going to use these tongs to mix it up because I'm not mixing it up with my hands. No. And I'm going to add some oil. Grapeseed oil. I'm gonna add some grapeseed oil. Just a couple little. We'll just pour some in there. We just gonna pour it in there. Okay. So we're gonna mix this all up. And I'm gonna start cooking early. What I'm gonna do though is I need to turn the oven on so I can. Because this is frozen solid. So I like for this at least to get halfway done. What time is it? It's 3. My family usually be home from working school around like 4 o'clock. Karai should be coming in the door about 3:30. Corey should be coming in about 4. So I'll just put everything on at 4. That's what I'll do. And then everything should be done by like 5. Yeah, because I don't want to be eating dinner too late. And we have a tendency to eat late. And that ain't good. That really ain't good. So I don't want to eat too late. Also, I'm going to be making some lemonade. I haven't made no lemonade in a while. I usually, like in the summer months, I usually make lemonade and sweet tea all the time. I really haven't made no sweet tea in a while. And I'm trying to cut back on sugar. So I'm trying to make it and not have a lot of sugar in it. I do have my corn soaking. I like to like rinse off my corn. You know what I'm saying? I like to rinse that off. Because, I don't know. Just to clean it. I don't like to just put it straight in a pan from... I don't like to just put it straight in the pan from the package, so I like to rinse that off. And what else? I gotta get my pan, and I need to get the pot for Lord Jesus. Y'all, I need to get the thing for the lemonade, the pan for the corn, and I need another pan for my broccoli, because we are having broccoli. We gotta have some type of vegetable, okay? Some type of green vegetable. I like to have a green vegetable when I make dinner. Green. Okay. But yeah, oh you guys, and also the viral karma waters. I don't know if y'all hip to them. Get hit, but they basically just a probiotic water. It's a probiotic water, and this flavor is berry cherry. It's pretty good. I like them. It's crazy that this is going viral and everybody is getting them, but I've been really on like trying to find a good probiotic, and I have bought these probiotics or whatever from, I don't know if I got these from either Walmart or Walgreens or CVS. No, I think it was from Walgreens. It might have been from Walgreens. But I heard that the probiotics that's supposed to be like in the refrigerator section. Like, I don't know if y'all go to like a health food store, like they got probiotics that's like in the cold section. And them supposed to be, I don't know if they're supposed to be the best or whatever, but I always thought they was, so I don't know. We're gonna set that there. Cause I'm not, what time is it? Okay. It's 2:28. So, yeah, I always thought, but what you do is, like, all the probiotic stuff is in the top. You press this down, and then you see it started to go in, y'all. It started to go in, and then you just shake it up, and drink it. And they're pretty good. I like them. So, Walmart, they sell them, like, individually, but I heard Sam's Club sell them by the case. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Sam's Club and get some. Well, I don't have a Sam's Club membership, but my girl, Tanya, she has one. So I am going to hit her up. Well, I already hit her up. So when she go to Sam's Club, I'm going to get a case of those. Because I have Costco, and Costco do not have these. And I'm about to get a BJ's membership because they building one closer to me. So I'm gonna get a BJ's membership, and I'm gonna go to BJ's, but I don't know if BJ's carry these either, but I know Sam's Club do. So your girl gonna go get some. But yeah, these are good, and it's a good way. They got a lot of vitamins in them. They got a lot. If y'all want to check it out, I suggest y'all go check it out. But I'm about to down this. Like I said, it's not bad. It actually really tastes good. But yeah, I'm deciding to seriously get my life on track, y'all. Your girl gotta get her life together. If y'all know me, y'all know my friends, y'all, they will hear me say all the time, I'm trying to get my life together. And I am officially gonna do it this year. I'm gonna do it this year. I feel like my year is starting over in February. I'm going to start my year over in February. Like, January, I just couldn't get it together like I wanted to. I just didn't start off the year on the right foot. You know what I'm saying? I really didn't. It didn't start off on the right foot like I wanted it to. So, February, I feel like we're going to start it off in February. Because today is like the 30th, right? Today is the 30th, I believe. Let me look at my phone. Yes. Today is January 30th. So your girl about to get her life together February 1st, okay? I'm gonna get it together. I am going to try to do everything I want to do, and that is I'm gonna start working out again. I'm gonna start trying my hardest to get up in the morning. I'm gonna become the morning person that I need to be. Because y'all know it's been a struggle for me. It's been a struggle. I have been struggling with being a morning person. Struggling. But I ain't gonna struggle no more. I'm gonna start taking my butt to sleep early so I can stay up in the morning. Even if I don't have an accountability partner, I'm just gonna do what I gotta do. I'm too grown. Too grown to not get myself together. Okay. So yeah, I am going to start getting my ass up and staying up. Let me rinse this out. I'm gonna get up and stay up, and I'm gonna make sure that I get myself together. I need to have a good morning routine. So I'm trying to get that together. My thing is with me, it's like when stuff starts to feel like it's taking too much energy, like work, like I started not wanting to do stuff, and then that's when I fail at it because I'll be like, oh, I gotta, you know what I'm saying? So I gotta just get that out of my mind. But I do need to get myself in shape. And actually, I think me and hubby gonna work out tonight. I'm starting to get on the schedule with my deliveries too. I think I'm only going to do it on the weekends because the weekends are just a little bit better for me. You know what I'm saying? If I do it during the daytime of the week, then I feel like I can, you know, do a little bit good too. But I can't go out every day during the week. There'd be stuff I'd be needing to do at home. And when I don't do what I need to do at home, I feel like my house just started falling apart. Like, like I said earlier, you know what I'm saying? My husband, he be trying to clean up, but he don't clean up like I clean up. You know what I'm saying? It's like he don't see stuff that I see. So, yeah, I be having to keep my house together. So, I think I'm just going to try to make it more so a really, really part-time weekend side hustle type thing. And then I can just really put more effort into my YouTube and into everything else I try. I'm having going on. But yeah, I'm starting my year over, February 1st. I'm starting my year over. But we got the oven on. I think it's warmed up. What time is it again? Okay, it's 3:33. Okay, yeah, the oven is on, warmed up. Like I said, I'm not really gonna put anything in until 4 o'clock. That's when I'm gonna start cooking everything. And actually, I'm gonna start cooking the chicken first because the chicken literally is gonna take a little bit longer. So I'm gonna cook this. I'm gonna get the chicken together first. Okay, we got the jug filled up. And I just need to clean these lemons off. I'm trying to down this. Y'all see how much I drunk already. Let me down this. Oh, I got a drop left. I'm trying to down it. I just like, when I take stuff like this, any kind of medicine or something I need to drink or something I need to just get down, I just try to down it so I could be done. I think that's Karaya coming home. Yeah, Karaya's coming home, y'all. I just try to be done with it. Even though this is good. This is really good, but I just want to get it in me. You know what I'm saying? And we're done. Just like that. Hey, Karaya, how's it going?
Good.
You look a hot mess, girl. What you was doing, rolling in the dirt?
No.
Why are you so dirty?
I got into a little argument at school.
What? You got into an argument? You got into a fight?
No, it wasn't like a real fight.
Who are you getting into an argument with?
So listen, me and my friends were just playing. And then this group of boys just came up and started messing with us, and we told them to leave. And they were kicking sand at us.
Really?
So I went up to one of them, and I told them to stop. And then they pushed me, so I pushed them back. And then he pushed me again harder, so I pushed him again. And then he fell on the floor. And then he got up again. And then I pushed him again. And then I started pushing away the other boys.
Really?
Yeah.
So you was the only one pushing the boys?
No. My other friends were like arguing with them, but I was like the first one that got into a fight with like one of the boys.
Do they live over here?
I don't know.
They live.
I forgot that the school. Name.
But did you tell the teacher? It was during gym?
Yeah, PE.
PE.
I forgot his name.
But he like in your class?
No, he's in another class. I don't know what.
Is he in a grade higher than you?
No, he's in the same grade as me. I don't know anything about him. I just know what he looks like.
And they was kicking dirt at you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I won. At least I won.
Well, that's good. You won.
I actually won the fight. And then he ran away. And then after I pushed him on the ground again, I started walking up to him. And then he just ran away.
Okay.
And we told the other boys to come on, and the other boys went.
I don't want you to be fighting boys. You did the right thing. If somebody hit you, you definitely hit them back. You definitely protect yourself. So I'm happy that you did that. But don't keep going after them.
Well,
I mean, if they're coming after you, yes. But if they stop coming after you, don't keep going after them.
And I won, and my friends were like congratulating me. Like, you won the fight, you gotta tell your mom.
But listen, next time a little boy puts his hands on you in school, yeah, you hit back. If anybody puts their hands on you, you hit back. You always defend yourself.
My friend was like, you have to tell your mom that.
But I want you to tell the teacher too.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't want them to do anything to really hurt you. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So you always need to tell the teacher, like, that little boy put his hands on me. You know what I'm saying? You mm-hmm. need to get their name.
We were actually like playing in the sand before they came, so it mm-hmm. wasn't them kicking. Okay. We were legit like making little castles.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, well, that's what's up.
I won.
That's all you care about is you want to fight, huh?
Yeah. Okay. And all my friends saw it.
But the teachers ain't see it?
No, I don't know how. Like, there was literally, everyone was gathering by the tree, and everyone was watching, and not one person told the coaches.
Correct. Next time, you need to tell the teacher. I'm mm-hmm. not playing. If somebody hit you, you hit them back, but you tell the teacher, okay? Mm-hmm. I don't want you getting hurt, especially with no little boys.
I honestly thought I was going to get, like, in trouble.
By who, me?
No, the teachers, because I remember you said, if you ever get into a fight and they hit you first, then you won't get in trouble at home.
No, you're never going to. If you defending yourself, you're never going to get in trouble. Now, if you start a fight, yeah, you don't start fights. But no, if somebody hit you.
I don't do that.
I know.
Why would there be a
I'm just saying, that's the only time you would get in trouble if you start a fight. But if you are defending yourself, if somebody hit you and you hit them back, mm-hmm. you would never get in trouble. Because mm-hmm. you're defending yourself. You don't let people hit you. Yeah. Okay. Well, go change your clothes. Go get in the shower, please. Oh, and you gotta clean up that room. That room looked like a tornado. A tornado went through it. And I'm not happy about that. So, shower first and then clean up your room. Thank you.
Shower.
Shower and then clean. Shower and then clean. Thank you. Oh, wow. That girl got into a doggone fight. I'll be back, y'all. Okay, y'all, so this is how dinner is looking. I got my macaroni and cheese with my broccoli mixed in. So good. I got, shut up. You gonna say I didn't even burn nothing? That's why I don't like to cook. That's why I don't like to cook. I got my chicken looking good. And then my corn on the cob. And I am about to eat, y'all. But yeah, I'll be back. Hey guys, what's up? So I just ate. Now I'm relaxing. And we are actually watching You People. And it's so good. It's so good. I love Lauren London and Eddie Murphy and Nia Long and yeah, so it's good. So I'm just laying on the couch. Cry, are you serious?
What are you doing?
Why do you have all three apples?
That's what I could have them.
So that means that you're gonna, what you gonna do with them?
Like,
what you doing with three apples?
Just eat one.
Put it back. Put them apples back and eat one apple.
Where were you going?
Like, yeah, you just walked in front of us with three apples.
Mom, aren't you gonna like include me in this such a good show that you're saying?
We don't know if you can watch.
You're right. You need to go back upstairs. I don't know if this is a kid appropriate show. And I don't really don't want you going upstairs and eating your apple. What you looking at me like that for? And another thing, clean up your room. Alright, we about to finish watching this video, y'all. I'll be back.
Are you gonna be? Say that you're gonna be.
Tell you what I did last night. I came home, say, around a quarter to three. Still so high, hypnotized in a trance from this body. So buttery brown and tantalizing. You would have thought I needed help from this feeling that I felt. So shook, I had to catch my breath. Ooh, there goes my shirt up over my head. Oh my. Ooh, there goes my skirt dropping to my feet. Oh my. Ooh, some kind of touch caressing my.
Yeah.
butterfly tattoo right above your navel. Your belly button's pierced too, just like I like it, girl. Come take a walk with me. You'll be impressed by the game that I kick to you. It's so thorough and real.
Flowers to be home in the summertime. You're ready to be watered by this conversation. You're ready. I'm in awe cause you shine like the sun. Let me be the one to enjoy you.
Enjoy you.
Let's kick it, girl.
So slow down. I just wanna get to know you.
Right here, so let's go ahead and get into it, y'all. I have been putting this off for a while. It's a new year. I was supposed to clean up my whole house from top to bottom. I didn't do that because I had a lot of family over and it just threw me all off, so I'm getting into it now. Whatever, we're gonna get it done anyway. So this is the closet. It is my coat and my shoe closet. I do not have a light in here because yeah, I need to get one. So, I'm about to show y'all how it looks. So, this is the top. I had this organized way better, y'all. It was so neat. Oh my gosh, why is it doing that? Okay. So, it was so neat. And it's just like a whole bunch of bags and stuff. Then we have the coats, the jackets, and at the bottom, the shoes. And yeah, so we about to get this together. I am going to be taking things upstairs. I do not need to be down here. Yeah, but I don't wear shoes in my house, so I try to keep all the shoes down here in here, but they always end up by my front door because, and we don't even use the front door. Like, people come in the back door and put their shoes by the front, and I'll be like, here's where the shoes go. The shoes go in here, and like, and it always end up over there. But anyway, we about to get into it. I don't know how this is about to be because, as y'all can see, I ain't working with a lot of space. I have my storage closet over here open so I can use this light because I don't have no light over here. So I don't know how this is about to work. Let me see. Let's see if I can do this. That right there. Let's see if I can put y'all in this closet. Would that help? That'll make it a little bit better. But yeah, so I'm about to start with getting all this stuff off the top and trying to see where all this stuff goes, because it's just too much. Let's see. Let's, of course, I need a chair because I am super short. So we just got a whole bunch of like shopping bags. I was actually looking for this hat. It's just a plain hat. I've been looking for it. My daughter broke my Coach umbrella. I'm so mad. This was a gift, so I gotta throw that away. We're just gonna do that. I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. Oh, these is Kariah old shoes. Y'all, it's just so much junk. We gonna get it together though. I think that I will keep. So I got another one of these for my back door, y'all. And my other one broke. Someone broke it. So I just gotta put it on. I ain't put it on yet. We have some water balloons for the summertime for the kid. And she also has some sidewalk chalk. So I'm gonna leave this up here. That can stay. Okay, so now we're gonna work with this stuff right here. So I have like 1,001 of these bags. They are just like those reusable grocery bags. Where this from? I don't even know where this from. But I have so many of them. I have a bunch of them from Trader Joe's, because y'all know I'm a Trader Joe's girl. These are my little table mats. They need to be cleaned off. So I am going to take these upstairs and put them in the laundry room, because they all need to be clean. So we'll do that. But again, Trader Joe's, we got a lot of Trader Joe's bags. I should actually be keeping these in my car for when I actually go to Trader Joe's or go to any grocery store. Another Trader Joe's bag. I can have bags, but you know, it's just so many bags, y'all. I'm trying to do my part with this environment. But I must say, I do like my plastic grocery bags. I ain't gonna lie. They come in handy when you need trash bags. Okay, one more. This is an old bag. Alright. So what I will do is, I am gonna put this back up there. But now all the bags are neatly there. All the bags are neatly in there. So like I said, these are going upstairs to get washed. We have a lunch bag here. I think I might put this in here. All right, I'm gonna have to bring y'all down so y'all can see what's going on. Okay. This is a like a wine gift bag. I think I want to keep this. Somebody gifted me a bottle and they put it in here, but when I want to take a bottle to somebody else's house for an event or something like that, I feel like that's good to keep for that purpose. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this little bag, y'all. This little Cracker Barrel bag. Should I keep it or not? I mean, it is a cute little bag. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it, though. I'll keep it. I just got so many bags. Okay, now let's get to all these jackets. These winter coats, this is my coat from when I lived in Ohio, y'all. I don't know. I mean, they're going to have to stay here, stay in the closet, because I'm not putting them nowhere else. And then we just have jackets and hoodies. I guess this stuff can stay. All the jackets and hoodies can stay. Now we just need to work on the bottom portion, which is the shoes. If we can get down to the nitty gritty. Let's see. The shoes. So what I need to do is, I'm gonna take all these shoes basically upstairs. The majority of them is my husband's shoes. I don't even wear these. Listen, living in Florida, I got these shoes in 2018 and they still look brand new because I was living in Ohio. It was, you know, winter, fall coming along. So I was like, let me buy these. You know, these little cute boots. I probably wore these maybe 3 times. Like, I have not worn them. I wore them here. I put them on one time here when it got, like, down to 30 degrees, and that was it. And I have not worn them, so they're going upstairs. All of this old stuff. Karai probably can't even fit these little sandals. We got a bunch of stuff up here. Shoes that she don't wear, sandals, my little beach sandals, which will stay because I can still wear those. Jump ropes. Should I keep these downstairs or take them upstairs? I think I'm gonna keep these downstairs because they can be used for exercising purposes. Exercising purposes. These shoes, y'all, I don't even know if this girl can still fit this stuff. I don't know. Size 2, she cannot fit these. She can't fit none of this. None of it. I'm hot. There. Oh, and then Karaya got a hoverboard, y'all, that she don't even use no more. Grocery bags that don't need to be in here. I guess I can put the hoverboard back in the case. The hoverboard can stay, actually. We got basketballs. And then look at all that dirt. Do y'all see that? Can y'all see all of that? I don't know if y'all can see that. Of course you're gonna fall. Let's take all this shit out of here.
I be so sick of you niggas, y'all don't you think?
I be so bold with myself, can you come and fuck me? I feel so ordinary, serving you around me. Treat me like gold, or I can me out. Arguments, you can air me out. Tripping about your whereabouts, I can't keep no conflict with you. Boy, can we just rub it out? I don't want no sad with you, you know you my plug. And I can't shake this habit, no.
Okay, y'all, so that was quick and easy. I'm done with this closet, and we're going to move on to the closet upstairs. But I just want to show you guys what I did. Organized all the bags, put that in that corner, hung up most of the jackets that was hanging up on here, and then organized the shoes, taking most of the shoes upstairs, and mop and swept the floor. So we're going to move on to upstairs and get that done. Okay, y'all, so we have the second location, my upstairs linen closet. Now, this closet is just a mess. It's an absolute mess. I have laundry that I need to fold up to put in here, and y'all see that these is all sheets right here. This row I usually leave for Kariah. So what I usually do with her is I have her own, she has her own set of towels, wash rags, and all of that. So I try to leave this area for her. This one was literally just our extra, you know, sheets and fitted sheets and regular sheets and stuff like that, pillowcases. And then this up here was just extra towels that basically I leave for like company or something spills or something like that, because I don't like use these towels on an everyday basis. There's some old towels up here that's just, you know, just like I don't want to throw away because we might need them for something. So I got laundry in there, I got more towels and stuff like that that I need to fold and hang and put in here. But I think I'm going, and then it's extra wash rags. So the extra wash rags I think is also in the laundry as well. So I am going to make, I just need to fix these shelves to make them neater. Like, you know, like look at how her towels is folded, y'all. Like they are just not just through in there any kind of way. So I kind of just like want to make everything neat, like make it neater. Just make everything look neat. You know what I'm saying? For her. Now, how people fold up their towels, I know people be folding towels different ways, and you know, I really don't care. I care, but I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Like, I do want them to like fit. And then I need to have this section up here also for just like extra shit that I got in here. Like, this should be here. This is a scarf, this Kariah's. I don't know why it's up there. I don't know why it's there. Like, I don't even know why, you know, like she don't even need a scarf here. Maybe one day out of the whole year. Oh, I forgot about this stuff. Okay. So yeah, like stuff like that. I'm gonna leave this type of stuff up there. Got extra kids' toothbrushes, my urn. Oh, these are essential oils, y'all. This was for my diffuser. Oh, it smells so good. Oh, as soon as I opened it up, it smelled so good. This was for my diffuser, but my diffuser broke. But yeah, we'll keep them. And then here are some more essential oils too. I gotta buy another diffuser. Oh, it smells so good. Or was this for my diffuser? This is 100%. I think I bought these when I was doing my LOSV glam, matter of fact. These wasn't for my diffuser. These was for me to put in my products. I was putting these in my products. But they are going to just be there. I'm going to get another diffuser, and I am going to make sure that we put it in there. So, yeah, I like these. I never use this sheet ever. But, yeah, I'm going to start putting all of that up there. All these sheets can just go. I want to fold them nice and neatly, but it's not working out. All right, I'm going to come back, y'all. This is Kariah's old pillowcase. Yeah, she got to have her own shelf with her own stuff. I always did her like that when, since she's been a baby, I always, like, washed her stuff separately from our stuff and kept her stuff separate. I don't know, it was just easier that way. So, I guess y'all can watch me work. I don't know what else to say. We're gonna try to get this stuff folded. Let's see.
Your heart is hard to carry after dark. Try to blame for what we could have been, cause look at what we are. Your friends are scared to tell you you went too far. Funny that it's always been all about you from the start. I met someone new last night and we kicked it. And I'm going back there tonight. And you know what's on my mind this time. Going back there tonight. And you know what's on my mind. So
once I actually started doing the video, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to make this a February reset. So, because I really want to start my year over in February. I think I'll do this every year. But anyway, yeah. So, like I said before, January really didn't go how I wanted it to go. I mean, it went okay, but it just wasn't everything I wanted it to be. It didn't start off on the right foot. It was just like a mess. So, yeah, I'm starting over on a fresh new slate, new start, starting the month off on the right note. Your girl gonna be exercising, your girl gonna be getting up early, all of that. So yes, this is my February reset video, and I'm just gonna give you guys a little dig into what your girl will be doing in February. Like I said, I'm getting back on my planning. I kind of fell off of my planning journey and my journaling and all of that stuff like that. I kind of fell off on that. Coming into the year, I like, the end of last year, I was like, I'm about to hit it hard. I'm about to be on my stuff. And it just was a dud. So, I am starting off the new year right. Y'all, I didn't even make a vision board yet. Like, I have a blueprint of a vision board. Like, I got stuff written down. But I haven't, like, made my vision board like I usually make. So, that is something that I am doing today. And like I said, the exercising, I really want to get it together this year. Like, I'm really happy that one thing I did commit to for January was no drinking. I did not drink for the whole month of January. Like, yeah, I had a drink New Year's Eve, you know what I'm saying? But I'll tell myself I'm committing to literally not drinking for the whole month of January. And I did it. And I'm proud of myself. Like, I'm really proud of myself. So, that's one thing going forward with this year. It's like, I really do want to commit to sticking to the things that I want to accomplish that would help me out in life. Like, for real. Like, I always fall off and I always be like, I'm gonna quit this and start this and quit that. No, not this year, not this month. We're gonna get it together. So I am going to get my planning back on track, digital, and, you know, just writing stuff down. And also, you know, just staying consistent. Like, consistency is key. You know, laying my foundation is key, and I just want to stay on top of it. So that is what I am doing, you guys. I got my handy dandy computer. And yeah, I'm about to just get it started. I'm about to just get my life organized and on track. Yeah, and one thing I do want to say about the movie that I watched last night. So about that movie, y'all, you people, I know it's like the number one trending movie right now. It was really good. I really liked it. The only thing that I did not like about the video is the guy, Jonah Hill, playing Lauren London's boyfriend or whatever. Like, it's just such an odd couple. Like, the chemistry wasn't 100% there. I feel like if it was somebody else that they was more compatible with her, it would have been more believable. But, yeah, overall, the movie was really funny. Like, I will definitely watch it again. I love those type of movies. It was a really good movie. But, yeah. So, I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. I thank you guys so much for watching. But, yeah, this is my February reset. Your girl will be staying on top of everything that I have been falling off of. So, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching.
Let me tell you about this girl. Maybe I shouldn't. I met her in Philly, and her name was Brasha. See, we've been making love constantly. That's why my eyes are a shade black burgundy. The way that we kiss is unlike any other way that I be kissing. When I'm kissing, what I miss, won't you listen? Brown sugar, babe, I guess high of your love, I don't know how to be.